In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we praise and glorify your name. We thank you for the countless blessings that you have bestowed on us, especially the gift of life. We hope and pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit in each one of us, so that we may continue what you will us to do. This we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so good afternoon once again, everyone.
Good afternoon.
My recording. Okay. So again, this session is recorded. So if you have any violations or if you do not like to be recorded, just kindly inform me. But the main purpose why I record my session, that those who unfortunately cannot join us, no, due to poor internet connection, can still keep up with our class. Ay, shit. Can still keep up with our class by watching a recording of our class nga nakuha na siya, no, na nahuman na. So this has been a practice of mine since the pandemic, but dili jud ako siya religiously ma-follow since given nga I have limited storage sa ako ang laptop and usually heavy ang mga videos because my video recording would last an hour or more, no, depending on the class. Hopefully, okay na si YouTube. Mag-Japon. Sige na lang. Dayan lang sa recap. If okay ang panahon. Whole body. Okay. So, again, no, so lesson 2. Duhar man actually ka lesson si module 1. Very kuan na kayo siya, no? Very dali na kayo kay. Continuation na punta sa lesson 2, module 1. Next week, sa Monday, kay what we are going to do with that is maglantaw raman tag samples of the lesson plan, and then also try to compare them, try to discuss noon sa nakalian sa usa, compare sa PCAS, and then how it is structured. I know some of you already have an experience on making a lesson plan, and it really depends, no, on the institution, most especially among private schools. They have their own separate nga format, like an LSAR, which is different from, although similar man ang, na may ibang contest nga very similar kay parehas man siya nagunod ang lesson plan, pero naka-arrange lang siya differently and may mga added lang siya nga features, but may added siya nga kuan, like values, no? Values integrated siya. Okay, before you'll proceed with this, the standards kay very slow kay kung internet. For the meantime, we will just have a recap first of what we discussed last Monday. So, if you can still remember, di ba, we had an activity where I let you recall your ICT integrated experiences. No, some of you did made mention about most of your teachers are using PowerPoint presentations instead of kana mga traditional nga kuan instructional materials like Manila paper. So wala na siya karon, gagamit ata og PowerPoint presentation projector. Then some of you did this made mention of like speech laboratories, or you made use of computer for your ICT. And it's not just through hardware. You also discuss several software, just like katong ato ang nakita, no, nga ato na dong na mention ninyo, no, nga mga websites, okay, mga learning management systems like Quipper, Google Classroom, Google Meet, websites that is very helpful to your academics like Sci-Hub, Google Scholar, no, kana maying anak nga mga sites wherein it is useful when doing research. And to add gani, you have Laird, pano, Laird Statistics, SPSS, Megastat, no. Those are just some of the things that we discuss, and kana nga to ang nag-sharing tano sa mga previous experiences in using ICT. And not only that, it has been existing for a very long time, even up until karon, and even during the pandemic, ginagamit man Japon nato siya. Okay. So right after your presentation, we started with the definition of integrating technology in instruction. So this is not the definition of ICT, ha. This is still the integration of technology in instruction. So, diba, we've encountered several researchers that did discuss how technology should be integrated in our teaching. No, it's not just like di ba atong gi according kay John Pisifiano, ato ang gi-discuss last time nga integrating technology doesn't just mean that you're going to let your students go to a computer lab, let them use the computer and then that's it. No, walay integration, walay ka nang walay synthesizing or walay ka nang murag wala man lay ka nang discussion of how to process the skills nga na-learn sa mga bata. They're not even guided on what to do and what they should learn. So, there is already ICT integration when we effectively communicate what should be the learning outcomes sa estudyante once we finish this activity. Like, kay karon class, ang ato activity ron, istudluan ta mo on saon paghimo, o paghimo og mga activities in Google Classroom at the same time, upload activities in Google Classroom. So, yung learning outcomes ninyo, Ani, is mauni siya inyong makuha. At the end of the lesson, you'll be able to effectively upload any types of learning materials, instructional materials in the Google Classroom and know how to also navigate through the Google Classroom on your own. So, magana ba, no? You effectively communicate the learning outcomes sa inyong mga estudyante. At the same time, imo silang tudluan, asa mo adto, saan paggamit sa learning management system. And then, you also allow your students to navigate on their own without na your guidance. Igura ka nag-demonstrate, para kabalo sila asa mo adto, then tagana po sila nimo mga exercises so that they can also learn on their own. That is what we mean about integrating technology. It's not just, ay, naka-indicate sa kong lesson plan nga, ka na magamit ni computer, then that's it, no? No? So, muna siya, you have to mix both your pedagogy and also, no, technology, no, to make it happen, okay? So, muna, no, parsa nang magamit ka o libro, no, sa imuha nga discussion, imong ingnon nga, example, magpa-book review ka sa mga bata, may ngon na ka nga, basa lang ka ning libro o basahan ni ang tibuok ko an. Nya wala kay murag wala synthesis, wala jud kay kanang murag i-discuss sa ila nga mo ni siya ang inyong buhaton, man nilang makuha ng skills afterwards. No, wala. So, if you tell a student to read a book without any preparation for follow-up activities, wala kay activity nga isulti, ingon na ka nga basa lang kag libro dira. Then the book is not integrated, okay? So, you have to make sure that when you let them read the book, let them read a story in the book, there should be a follow-up activity to put that book in a pedagogical context para ma-value ni student nga, ah, okay, the reason why we're doing this activity, gamit mi computer karon or gabasa mi libro, is that at the end nga kanang makat-on mi, kabalo na mi unsaon paghimoog or pag-navigate sa LMS, or for example, kung basa ko sa libro, kabalo na ko nga kanang how to summarize the story from the book, kay we are told to summarize the story, or for example, identify, no, the main event, the climax, the important characters, no, maingana, no, pag-arrange nila nga pasunod, ano, in a chronological or pasunod ang mga sequence sa events, so maingana, dapat na siya purpose lang. Dili lang nga ihat, ibutan mo sa computer lab, mingon din ka nga, there is integration of technology. No, there should be a purpose behind it. So, di ba ito, na-mention na ito, no? We already cited several researchers, no? Silang John Pisipia and even the International Society for Technology and Education, which, di ba, si ISTE is patterned by DepEd sa ilahang ICT policies. Okay? So, this is basically the guidelines ni teacher on making sure that they use technology, integrate technology in their teaching, and the students also learn how to make use of technology so that they will become more creative, no, they will become more critical thinkers. Balikan na to si ISTE standards o niya, no? Proceed ta sa next. So, na-mention po na ito si Margaret Lloyd, no, nga ICT integration encompasses an integral part of broader curriculum reforms which include both infrastructural as well as pedagogical. So, infrastructural here are technology, no, hardware, and then ang pedagogical considerations, kaya ang imong ways of teaching, okay, your methods of teaching. So, mag-mix rin sila, no, kaya di man na pwede nga si technology ang mo overpower sa imong pagtudlo. There should be a balance between human intervention. No, na siya po'y part si teacher anak, no? At the same time, naapod siya ay participation ni technology. Okay, they work hand in hand. Dili kay si technology ang moy mo drive sa steering wheel. You as a teacher still drives the steering wheel, no? You're still in control of the class. And your tool, no? Your tool on how to get there, no? And how to really, ano, kanang make the students understand your lesson is through technology ra. Okay? So, may mga several people, no? Nga to ang gi-cite, no? On how they discuss, no? How ICT will be integrated into teaching. Okay? So, muna, no, according to Kion Wang and Huai Lit Wu, integration can happen in three different areas. You have the curriculum. So, the curriculum is basically your guideline, no? That will serve as your guideline on what are the contents that you need to teach, unsa yung time frame, diba? Unsa yung mga learning outcomes na need nimo i-meet, no? Sa imong lesson. And then, the topic and the lesson are basically detailed, no? Detailed na siya nga i-discuss, which is a smaller part of your curriculum. Okay, so muna na, we also discussed the process of integrating ICT and teaching and learning according to Bernard Bihati in 2010, which needs to be done at a both pedagogical and technological level with much emphasis to put on pedagogy. So, man siya kung giingon sa inyo, di ba, class? Dili man need na i-overpower ni technology ang pagtudlo ni mo, kundi again, ang emphasis is more on the pedagogy. And then, according to UNESCO in 2005, ICT integration is not merely mastering the hardware and software skills. And again, it's not enough that you master nga. Kabalo kung saan pag-navigate o kuan, kabalo kung saan pag-edit sa Adobe, no? Dili lang, no? Teachers also need to realize how to organize the classroom structure, a classroom to structure the learning task so that ICT resources become automatic and natural response to the requirements for learning environments in the same way teachers use markers and whiteboards in the classroom. So, just like any other explanation sa mga previous researchers nga to anang na-mention last Monday, according to UNESCO, no, dili lang na siya merely like, I know how to do this, or I know how to make use of the computer, I know how to make use of the learning management system. It's not that alone, no? Kabalo tuod ka, per kabalo po ka mo organize sa imong mga estudyante. Kay useless man nga kabalo ka aning your tech savvy, but you don't know how to organize your classroom, you don't know how to deliver the lesson, di ba? So, mauna siya. Igura siya nga magamit ang technology, we know how to do it, and we're proficient in using it, okay? But it serves just like a marker and whiteboard in the classroom nga. It's there to, you know, help you with teaching, even to, kano, kanang help you get the attention of your students, but not necessarily jud nga mo replace nimo as the teacher. Again, sa tanan nga mga gipang define, even pag last Monday pa, it's merely a tool for you to use, okay? To make your lessons more understandable, not something that will make your life easier by replacing you entirely. And that is what we want with AI, di ba? AI is already there, no? Ang mga schools before, nagkuyawan sila with the emergence of AI because they believe that would easily replace a lot of people, even teachers, because even nakatry me before, no? Naka-discover ko AI way back in January last year. I made an op-ed about it, pala ko siya na-publish akong op-ed. Sa katunga ko, na-realize ako dito sa, what you call this? Sa ko ang nabasahan nga, kalukas sa banong mga teachers good, kay mas dali mang good ma-explain ni AI compare sa teaching nga, we take 1 hour of lecture niya. Sometimes kay, kuan pa, lengthy pa kayo ang discussion niya. Mawala na dayon ang attention span ni student. With AI, you're just going to search ka, so, ano ko pag-compute, ani? How do you compute this and that? I remember, nakasulay po ko, anak, ay ipa-explain na ko ni AI kung saan pag-compute, ani, no, standard deviation, mo ni mauna, automatically, within just seconds, mahatag da yun niya. Okay, and even, himunin mo sa, okay, make a story, okay, make a 5-page script, movie script, no? Pero, unsa nakalayan, even if dali na kayo ang result ni AI, it loses human touch. magbasa ka, like, wala dyan siya emotions. Unlike sa actual person who is writing it, even ka nang nag-iuban nga mga films na gina-ridicule karon in pop culture na po tanong, na yung mga mga films gina-ridicule karon in social media because it seems like it was written by an AI. Kay it's so emotionless. Kay kita as human person, di ba? As human being, human person. As a human being, when we read stories or when we read scripts or when we watch movies that are very cathartic, may tag-cathartic ganit class ka nang murag maka-invoke na siyang emotions. Makaingon, magutagod nga, ay, person writing this is kaan dyan, no? Writing out of passion dyan. Mabitang kabantay mo nga, ano, kiligun man dyan mga K-drama. Because, you know, I experience sa mga female writers in Korea, they don't get the same affection and love sa mga male protagonists sa K-drama. Kaya mga K-drama nga mga laki, they are fictional. Kaya ang mga laki sa Korea in real life are very nonchalant. They're not affectionate. No, kaya naman yan, baka nang murag dili dyan siya. Hindi na siya typical dyan siya nga kung kabanti mo nga nung dali takiligon as babae ka ng mga K-drama. Because women are writing the scripts in K-drama stories. That's why dali kita kiligon because sila manggoy gabutang og mga expectations. Ang expectations nato sa mga babae, as babae, di ay sorry. Ang expectations nato as babae, ato manggong ginasulat siya sa kaninga script. Na dapat ang kaning protagonist nga lalaki, no, male protagonist nga lalaki, dapating ani iyang batasan. Muna di kita ma-fall in love ani nila. Because they have met our standards as girls. Ga, caring, loving. But again, it's all fiction, no? Because it's made up from the standards sa mga babay. Which wanted more because in reality, diliing ana ang mga lalaki sa Korea. So, yan, no, there is a cathartic feeling. You feel that a person is actually writing it. You feel like a person is actually writing it because it invokes a lot of emotion, and that is something AI can never duplicate, no? Although they might be sentient, wait lang for a while. They might be like sentient, na may mga sentient dira nga AI, di ba? Na may, wait lang. Okay. Na may mga sentient dira nga mga AIs or robots no nga have existed in the past na. It's not a new thing anymore. You can even put ka ng more consciousness sa usa ka robot. Because we're talking technology here, ha. You can even put like consciousness sa usa ka robot. But they can never truly feel what humans feel, no? Di man dud sila kaingon nga ka-express sila like emotions like any other people, no? So, mo po na siya, class. Munang maingon ta nga, there should be, even sa AI, di ba, muna yung kadlukan nila kay, people will be displaced, no? Writers will be displaced because usually, mga good people would write, with experience even writer's block, di ba, magpasulat ka nilag script. Kuna sila yung writer's block, usahay, mampan pa nagpila ka si mana, usap pa nila ka ng mahuman ang usa ka manuscript, no? Kaya, syempre, we get tired, we get exhausted, we have writer's block, we get mag-usahay murag wala tay inspiration to write anymore. Unlike sa AI, they never get tired. So when you make them write something within a couple of seconds, they can just write it, no? So ang naka-difference ng jud ana, although paspas jud sila, again it loses human touch. There are no emotions in it. Even if you let them write a story or a script, there are no emotions at all. You can never feel or sympathize or murag di ka feel cathartic, no nga ng kuan ng emotion or feelings ani nga what they call this a script because it's written by an artificial intelligence, no, or by artificial intelligence rather. So this is what we are also going to talk about in integrating technology in our teaching. That's why technology can never replace us as teachers, kay our students can also learn from us. If sila mismo kakita na to, yung kita makabalo po ta sa progress sa bata, kay kita mismo makafeel man ta sa ilaha. Okay, we know their progress, we know what they feel, okay? We empathize with them if ever they feel nga naglisod sila sa klase. And that is something technology cannot do. Technology is just there to, you know, make teaching far more enjoyable, madali siya masabtan, di ba? Sumuna siya. Okay, let us now proceed to ICT itself, no? The previous researchers that you encountered to sa UNESCO, kato po mga paragraphs from UNESCO, ISTE, and then other researchers, those are about integrating technology in teaching. So let's now proceed to ICT. Okay? So before you can successfully integrate ICT in your language instruction, there is a need to have a good grasp of what information and communication technology is all about. Okay, most especially sa itong ICT policy set by DepEd, and even in our ISTE standards, the number one, kaya maram na siyang hagdanan, good, di mo ka makaambak sa number five, kundi ka maagto sa number one. So, ang pinakauna dyan, anak class, is syempre, you have to be aware of what is ICT all about, no, its entire context, as well as the ICT policies, which we already have established in TTL 1. Okay? Pero ito lang ang balikon karon for the sake lang po of continuing the discussion. Okay? Specifically, there is a need also to determine the ICTs that are available for language education. The following are the definitions of ICT from various sources. So, ito ano we are, kung sa ICT policies ta nata sa number 1, and then padulong ta sa number 2. So, sa number 1 ta, meaning we identify first ICT policies and its context. To give you an idea what I'm talking about, kung nagasigita o talk about ICT policies, about kung nagasigita talk about ICT and not making the lesson plan diretso, let me introduce first katong ICT policies set by DepEd. Para at least you will know, no, ang pagpasunod nato sa toang klase. Okay, it's in lesson 1. Sadly, we are still in lesson, step 2 pa mi ato sa TTL 1. Every Friday pa dyan, no, pero may maligsa, no, and I was really satisfied with my schedule, kay pulang kami sa time. Well, these are ISTE standards. I'll start with the first one. ICT competency standards for teachers. Alright, let me just... there are so many domains, actually. Ah, no, not steps, but domains. Alright. Okay, so sa domain 1, kailan na i-expand, ha? So, domain 1 is understanding ICT in education. Okay? So, dapat kabalo ka sa whole context of ICT, its role in education, the ISTE standards, where the ICT policies are patterned from. That's what we're doing right now. Then, on Monday, curriculum and assessment na punta. Okay? So, muna, demonstrate mo understanding of your concepts since nakasabot naman mo what are ICT policies, how we integrate technology in teaching. Mag-demonstrate na ito of understanding these concepts into what? No, in applying to teaching and learning. So, muna, curriculum and assessment, mag-develop taan na, no? Pedagogy is actually applying that one to classroom activity. So, syempre, curriculum pa man ta sa domain 2. So, next week, mag-domain 2 na ta. Mas basa na to, no? Ang among klase sa tibok semester, atong i-compress sa susa ka semana. So, di naman ta mag-go into details sa domain 1, kay dapat sa TTL 1 na siya ginapaagi. Ang domain 2, diretso dyan yung tana, no, dapat domain 2 na ganit may, domain 2, domain 3 na may sa TTL 1. Domain 2, muna next week, Monday, natin mga sample of our lesson plan, teaching guide, naapot tayo sample sa libro, mukha ko itong sa libro nga sample itong 13 days, 10 days ba ito siya nga learning plan. Then LSAR sa CSR, then lesson plan na po sa DepEd, dayon teaching guide pa dyan sa Santa Rita, no? At lang, ipang, lantaw lang, no? At ito, i-compare sa inyo nabantayan, guys. Anay mo niya na, mag-activity taan na. Then, on Wednesday, either mo-meet ko or dili sa inyo, pero kana siya intended for an activity next Wednesday to make your own lesson plan, okay? Ang kamupod mismo, so at least i-apply sa inyo, ha? Okay? So, yung ana. Pero at least before mo himog lesson plan, makasabot na mo nga, wala, dapat di ay kung mahimog ay kong mga activities sa ako ang klase, dapat dili lang ingon nga, o pagamitan ako computer ang mga bata, ani ha? Sa akong lesson plan, dapat nakabutang dira nga, ako sang i-discuss sa mga bata, unsay lang makatunan. Mula ito na sa preparation, di ba? Imuha pang, sa motivation mo, imuha pang i-communicate sa ila, ha? Unsay learning outcomes, ani nga activity. Dayon, imong i-introduce ng activity by demonstration. Dayon, sila na dayon. parties, they will value unsay purpose sa aning activity nga nugi pa computer sila. And ikaw pod, naadri tinuod nga ICT integration sa imuhang pagtudlo, okay? Which is present in your lesson plan. At least, kabalo na mo what you mean about ICT integration, okay? Before maghimog inyong kaugalingong lesson plan next week. Nakasabot ra tanan?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then, sa domain 3 muna, pedagogy, no? So, inyo nang i-apply for classroom activities. Okay? Depende na ninyo sa inyo ang pagtudlo, ana, no? Based sa inyo ang gimo nga lesson plan. That's under domain 3. Domain 4 is technology tools. Demonstrate mo competence. So, you know how to navigate different technology tools in teaching. Dilingon nga, kinanglan pa ka magkuhan, you know already where to go. And you're able also to demonstrate that one to your students through domain 5. Okay? So, manano, exhibit leadership in shared decision making. So, diri, not only that you are proficient in using technology in teaching in domain 5, you're also able to exhibit leadership by, what they call this, kanang marag, imuhang i-apply sa mga bata. O kung sa'yo mo nabalaan, imong i-apply sa mga bata. And imong lantaon if makasunod ba sila sa imuhang gitudlo sa ilaha. Okay? And then, teacher and professional learning. So, since you're already, like, proficient na in using different technology in teaching, domain 6 is more into further, no? Further pa jud nga enhancement sa imuhang proficiency in using technology. Okay? Mag-workshop ba ka? Mag-attend kang training? So, muna siya. Okay? Then, domain 7, same sa ISTE standards, diba? Sa 6th standard in ISTE, no? Is the standards ang unang kabuok no for teachers and then for students. Ika number 6 dito sa is the standards for teachers ang ethical, no? Understanding the ethical use of technology. And that is also the same with the 7th domain in the ICT competency standards for pre-service teachers. So, in here, dapat not only nga kabalo ka sa paggamit ng technology, you also know how to use it responsibly. Okay? Kabalo ka how to use it, hindi ka mag-plagiarize, no? Use it in an ethical way, hindi po ka mo abuse sa ubang tao using technology, o yung ana. So, use it for productive reasons. Balik po sa PICA. So, meron na itong sa TTL1, no? That's why, karon, napata sa domain 1. Ila sa tal, context of ICT in general. Next week, domain 2 na dayon ta. So, according to Morrison in 2005, which is a very outdated kaayo, no? Pero sige lang. ICT includes all the full range of computer hardware, computer software, and telecommunication facilities. We talk about ICT, information communication technology, nag-compare siya of both the infrastructure itself, computer hardware, and then the software, things that you cannot touch, but, you know, ginagamit mo, makita ni mo siya. And then, it includes also computer devices ranging from handheld calculators to multi-million worth supercomputers. That is why you can still say nga, there is still ICT integration in mathematics, even if you're just using calculator, even if you are just using spreadsheet. Because ICT integration does not only limit to hardware, or no, sorry, not only limit to kanang kuan lang, no, kanang mga websites alone, or PowerPoint presentation, or virtual reality, dili man jud na ing anara ang ICT. Even as simple as calculators, spreadsheets, making use of Word documents, no? Kanang mga Mentimeter, Jamboard, those are very simple applications. But, it's still part of ICT, okay? So, depende na, at least na, kay other than this typical pen and paper, at least you have other devices to use so that it's easier for the students to understand the lesson. Okay? Maski nga lang, muna, you don't have to feel sad if you feel like, lawe, ma-teacher ko, or kuan ko nga teacher, like, resource teacher, di man ako ma-apply tanan ning mga websites. Okay, limited raman ang ako ang kuan. Usually, mo gamit raman may, we're very practical sa mong subject, calculator ra, og spreadsheet ang mong gamit. And that is okay, that is still ICT integration. Masking calculator lang na, no? Masking ka ng Microsoft Excel, no? Di raman may nag-start, sa masteral ginamon, no? Before, may nag-SPSS. We may practice in Megastat. And Megastat is like an extension in Microsoft Excel wherein it can help tabulate our data for us. So it's easier for us, like, i-arrange siya among data, no? Get the mean, median, mode, mga nga, no? Simple descriptive statistics lang. Makaya na siya ni Megastat. Di siya nga nakabugat ng hinoon compared to SPSS. But that's an example of ICT integration because that's how practical mathematics is, diba? Numbers, mga word ko, yeah, di man tayo ingon nga, kanonology tayo, pwede man tayo magpa-quiz is, pwede man tayo magpakuan. Pero kung ginahan ka nga mag-calculator mo for the day, then pwede rapo kayo. Kaya depende na sa diskarte. Kay ICT, again, has a very huge coverage. Dala na siya limited to kuan lang dyan, no? To websites dyan. Eh. Dapat kuan dyan, magpa-quiz is dyan ko. Or dapat magpa-mintimeter dyan ko. Maski hindi dyan siya applicable sa imuha nga subject, di ba? So, part of ICT integration is also knowing what appropriate tools to use sa imong lesson plan. Okay? Iman yung pagsunta na lang dyan kayo para inun nga, nindot kayo mong klase. Kung sari appropriate sa mong klase, mura po i-apply. Okay? So, appeal na po na lang mga, even mga CDs, DVDs. So, very con na magkain niya. Mga daan na magkain ng mga DVDs, no? Kaya we have already YouTube naman, no? Mga digital cameras, computer games. Pwede man na. Ay, kuan. Sa robotics, pwede ganyan may kahim mo educational computer games. And then, that can also be part of learning. Depende na again sa discarte ni teacher. So, pwede po appeal ni ICT ang computerized machinery and computerized robots. So, in TINYO in 2009, ICT is a diverse set of technological tools and resources used to communicate, create, disseminate, store, and manage information. These technologies include hardware devices, software applications, internet connectivity, broadcasting technologies, and telephony. Okay? Kana po nga mong mga instructional materials class no, nga ka nang mag-video recording. Abi ko sa klase niya kung gina-upload sa YouTube and then for my students to watch, no? Or I have pre-recording videos, for example, if I have like a lot of time and then especially if busy ko, pwede ra ko mo send nila og recording, video recording for them to watch asynchronously so that naman sila makatunan while I am away or I'm not available for a synchronous class. Pwede nga na, no? Discarte na actually ni teacher. This one is a very recent source, no? From UNESCO. So, ICT, according to UNESCO, is a diverse set of technological tools and resources used to transmit, store, create, share, or exchange information. Anything that is used, no? Digitally, to store, create, or exchange information is part of ICT. Okay? It can include, again, computers, hardware, man na siya. Software, like the internet. Okay? And then, even live broadcasting, technologies like podcasting, audio, video player, storage devices, are also considered ICT. Manama, video conferencing, what we're doing now is already ICT integrated because we are making use of video conferencing. And then, share pa siya kong multimedia tools later on by using YouTube videos. Those are already ICT integration. Okay. So, UNESCO defines it as a scientific, technological, and engineering discipline and management technique use. ICT also refers to handling information, its application, and association with social, economic, and cultural matters. Okay. According to Rathi Swari in 2018, ICT influences every aspect of human life. And that is true, no? Because just like business, no? Malamang unta nga, business everywhere because schools are considered business. You pay money for us to provide you with better facilities, provide you with teachers who are qualified and well-equipped to give you the knowledge that you need, no? In order for you to be ready in the industry. Not only that, even hospitals are businesses because you're paying money for you to get better healthcare, diba? So, just like businesses everywhere, ICT is also everywhere and is an essential part of the human life because it again, it plays salient roles, no? May tag salient or pertinent, no? Important. Important roles in workplaces, in businesses, in education and entertainment. Kato ganing, di ba naman ito sa serious story nga? Basta ko nung ma-reach. Katong last year ba ito no nga? Kanang, nado ko ni, sana kanang solar flare nga. Mawala ko ng mga internet connectivity, wala na ko ni electricity. Yeah, ang uban, nagan kinabala ka ito no. Although, di man dyan may dali mutog mga yung anak. Pero, syempre, we understand why a lot of people are afraid and affected by it. No, masking fake news or hoax na ito siya. Because we rely so much on technology. Kami asa may manghog mga additional resources if wala may internet, di ba? Di man naingon nga, we rely on books alone. Books can just provide us with limited resources. And if we want to explore further, we make use of the internet, no? Not only that, no? It's easy to consume information if it's in a video, video type, no? If you watch movies, if you watch videos, educational videos, it's easy for us to absorb information in just a short amount of time because instead of reading, no, and then it's tedious to read, no. Let us not pretend that reading is enjoyable, although it is enjoyable, but not all the time, no. Sometimes we get tired, no. So videos can provide us with that luxury, diba? People make use of social media to do business, to communicate with their loved ones. Karon, you have online selling. You don't need to have a physical store to do business. You can have like your online shop, diba? So there are so many, even kita, you know, we can do video conferencing. Even if you are in the comforts of your own home, you can do things remotely through technology. So muna, it's an important aspect of human life. ICT, information, communication technology, all of that is an essential part of our human life, no? Basically, it's a necessity already. That's why I kept on saying, we should provide, I think our country should provide with better strong internet connection. In other countries, internet connectivity is no longer a luxury. It's a necessity. Luxury gani, only those who can afford it can enjoy it, which is dapat daan dyan yung mga infrastructures built so that they can accommodate strong internet connection nga. Anywhere ka mo agto na is strong internet connection. Makakonek na yung ka for free without paying anything because it's already it's a necessity already. Okay? Okay, muna siya, no? Internet provides us with information and we have the right to access to information, raba. We have a right to communicate with our loved ones, no? And part of making a destination more accessible is not just with the roads or ilahang mga transportation, but also if accessible bang sa kalugar through their means of communication, na by signal, na by internet connection, di ba? So moreover, many people recognize ICT as a catalyst for change. That includes change in working conditions, handling and exchanging information, teaching methods, so, teaching, conferencing in remote areas, mag-abot ra punta, no need naman nga moagto sa inyong lugar kung pwede naman mag-video conferencing na yung mga relasyon nga gapadayon masking LDR kay syempre with technology o wala siya learning approaches, scientific research and accessing information communication technologies. Okay, even karon, no, I really appreciate doing research now compare sa mga nga panahon nga we had to go to the library. Kaya we have limited resources sa una sa library eh. Kaya una siya ang internet, maski kuan lang, just one click of the button, you can search anything, no, with AI pagani. It can give you with just dalira, no, just a few seconds lang. That's why we are so impatient. If you've noticed, our generation today are so impatient because we're so used to instant, no? Instant gratification, instant na dayo, no? We don't work already for what we want because, you know, we're so used to getting things easily. Okay, so yung anak, no? That's why we don't have the patience for it. We don't have the patience for hard work. We rely on what is easy na lang or asa ang sayon. Kaya muna, technology provides us with that luxury. Okay. So in this digital era, no? So ICT is important in the classroom for giving students opportunities to learn and apply the required 21st century skills. ICT improves teaching and learning and helps teachers perform their role as creators of pedagogical environments. Again, it improves teaching. Wala siya nag-replace teaching. ICT helps a teacher to present his or her teaching attractively. So, malaki nga ninyo, no? Maka-add siya og attractiveness sa inyong klase. Kaya, syempre, students will see different pictures, na different visuals, something new na put aside from the usual nga naara sa classroom. And then, it's not just limited to our department or our level alone. You can integrate it into any year level. Okay? Mapag-graduate school man, mapag-elementary. Although, lain-lain lang ang ilang needs, but you still make use of ICT, no? To help our class. Questions?
None, ma'am.
Okay. So, din na ito sa point na I am going to introduce the different ICT frameworks in language education learning plans. Pero before ito na, ako sa itong ikon. Pwede ba na ako tumalan ito itong ISTE standards? Wait lang ha. Try ako if pwede na ako kag-go sa YouTube kay before tamo proceed, malantaw tamo sa ISTE standards. Lesson plan, syempre. For midterm, I'm planning to do that, no? Nga, you'll be making your own multimedia tools, no? Oh, bangi ginapa-contest nila eh. I'm also planning to do that. Pero, alang, namang example na kita sa obang AR school ba? And again, it depends on your creativity. I'll give you the freedom to choose if you're going to have it through video or you're just going to have it through like video jud ba nga kanang marasyag ka na makita nga ni mo sa mga reels nga kanang educational nga kanang gatok siya niya na ay mga graphics nga nakabutang. Nahimo na sa akong mga tourism students before sa lang tour guiding nga ay naka-flash pa tong pag-pandemic, tong dili pa ta face-to-face pag-pandemic pa. Na naka-flash lang screen nga mga destinations. So, yan, ano lang. For example, maglakaw-lakaw mo sa facade sa school or maglakaw-lakaw mo sa school grounds. Yeah. You're talking about the 6 ISTE standards for teachers or the 6 ISTE standards for students. Yan, na yung naka-pop up sa gawa sa like, sa side ninyo ng mga words or visuals. Ngayon, ana. You can do that one in TikTok, actually. I've made one. Marag one night, rato na ko tunahin mo, no? Katong sa amo ang CGSP nga koan. Rapod siya similar sa ISTE standards pero more siya on guest service. Lagi mo ko yung ano niya, TikTok ra kong gamit. Niya, naka-green screen ra ko. Pero pwede man nga ka actual video siya, butangan lang ninyo mga text. So, galakaw-lakaw mo kunuhay, ga-explain what is ISTE standards na yung nakagawas na video. That could be like an informational na video, no? Or, pwede po, like lecture, no? Nga, naakay slides naka-prepare what are is the standards, then you record yourself. You can make use of Zoom to do that. I do that a lot of times, pero dapat dili ka mula pasok 60-40 minutes, no? Or maski gani diri na lang sa Google Meet ninyo, open mo own Google Meet using the CSR email, wala siya time limit. Di ba necessarily 1 hour po din yung discuss, no? Pila raman ang is the standards, so mo talk mo, no? Nya hatag og example from YouTube. So, naa siya slides niya. Mag-discuss ra ka about it, no? Mayroon ka. Morning, everyone. My name is Teacher Cybel. As if teacher mo. Teacher Cybel. And today, I will be explaining about the 6 ISTE standards for teachers. And then, kayo mga PowerPoint nga nakakuan. Imuring i-record imong self gamit sa Google Meet. Da yun, naka-share screen ka. Although, wala mo na i-recording sa Google Meet sa kung ano, di rin ano kay, di naman di ita premium account. But I don't know if maka-record ka with Zoom. If you can have like screen recording, pwede man. Discord, does Discord have screen recording? I don't know. I haven't explored Discord. I have Discord before, pero wala kayo ka-explore. Ano, no? Pag-pandemic, rakaayo to. So, yung nga, I'm planning to do that nga activity no sa inyo ha, on by midterm. Sa curriculum sa ta, lesson plan sa ta una. O sa ta maghimo atong mga infographics. Sayang no, hindi na ako mapakita. Pero sige lang. Ano ko, is the standards. Okay. So katong video sa kong gi-sansay ko tong group chat, you just watch that on your free time and I do hope that mulan taw jud mo tanan, no? Kasi hindi mo ko pa-activity ani, pero sooner or later you will make an activity out of the ISTE standards. Okay? Either informational video with text, with visuals, and then with an actual background nga naa mo sa school, and or you have the choice, if wala mo ikuan to do that, wala mo resources to do that, pwede man mara good mo ga present good ga video mo sing kagalingan while discussing the ISTE standards. Para sa anino, naka video recording ta, and then ga share na ka sa slides, ga discuss ka sa slides, but syempre make it engaging po nga as if kanang marapog kag kanang ga vlog, no? Nga hi everyone, so today you will be learning about the 6 ISTE standards, so we just share to you muna na siya, discuss na yun nimo. You have an option to do ISTE standards or the ICT policies for pre-service teachers, those 7 domains. Although I do prefer the ISTE. Okay, dira man naging pattern ang ICT policies. Let us continue. Okay, let us proceed in using ICT integration frameworks in language education learning plans. So there are several learning plans actually. In ICT integration, no, there are a lot of concepts provided by experts. Ang uban ani kay maybe it's a product of their research, no. They made a theory and then they provided a framework out of it, no. So these concepts are very helpful in providing clarity, no, on how technologies are properly integrated in the teaching learning process. Okay, let us start with, so parang ginagamit siya sa classroom, no? Yung mga ICT integration. Move forward lang ta. Okay, so for this purpose, following this framework that I will be introducing this afternoon may serve as a guide in integrating ICTs in developing learning plans or lesson plans in the different subjects, particularly in developing learning plans or lesson plans in the language education. So, ang pinaka-first nga framework, I think there are 4 frameworks akong introduced, no, this afternoon. If ito mahuman, kaya mapunta sa time, pwede man siya Monday, and then after sa mahuman na to ang kanyang discussion, dito lang tao sa mga examples sa learning plan. So, we have the conversational framework of Laurel Yad in 2002. So, the teaching learning process poses very complex skills to allow learners to understand their lessons and master the skills they are expected to demonstrate. Okay, so it will be reassuring if si teacher will not just focus on one media alone, but will explore different, various media to support various learning activities in the classroom. That is why the conversational framework is introduced, no, through this. The framework postulates a way of presenting teaching and learning in terms of events. And it's not just like one media alone, but you can choose several medias that will help you throughout your teaching. So, sa conversational framework ni Laurel Yad, so di mo siya yung framework siya nga na yung mga like, schematic diagram, although naaman siya sa 3 fundamental ICT integration ni Wang, pero ang kay Laurel Yad is more siya on like gitabulate lang siya, pero gibase siya sa 5 teaching and learning events. Okay, kani mga 5 teaching and learning events kay acquisition, discovery, dialogue, practice, and creation. Okay, so the 5 areas, if very small sa inyong screen, pwede rin yung i-pinch ang screen para ma-expand. So, i-pinch lang ninyo na ang kanang screen dira nga naka-share sa inyong cellphone para ma-expand siya further, or you rotate your screen so that it will be naka-landscape, no? So, the 5 events are specific teaching strategies, learning actions, or experiences related media form, examples of non-computer-based activity, and examples of computer-based activity. So, nakatunga siya, no? Kani, naka-base ang framework ni Laurel Yad sa kaning 5 ka-teaching and learning event. Putol pa gani, oh. Putol siya. Wala napil ang creation. Only practice. K. Okay. Napana siya creation sa Obos facilitating. I'll just send you a photo again that you can follow with my discussion. Wait lang. I'll try to search the lower liad po sa koan na to, ha. Okay, sent the table already over to our group chat. So we have the lower liad. 5, acquisition, discovery, dialogue, practice. The last one is creation. So wala siya sa obos, no? Naputol man siya. So under acquisition, divide siya sa teaching, action, or strategy. Learning action or experience, related media form, examples of non-computer-based activity, and examples of computer-based activity. Okay, so ang teaching action or strategy is, show, as a teacher, ha, show, demonstrate, describe, or explain. In order for a student to, acquisition of knowledge, so you have to demonstrate it to them, describe, no? Show to them how it works, show to them what the lesson is, no, explain everything to them so that makasabot sila. On the end part ni student, syempre, once they attend the classes, no, they will listen, they will comprehend, no, apprehend what the teacher is demonstrating, what the teacher is explaining. Okay? So, unsay related media form, usually ginagamit, no, under the teaching and learning event of acquisition. So, sa teaching mo ni siya, no, part ni teacher mo ni, tudlo ko ning mo, by demonstrating, by explaining. Sa learning part ni student, maminaw siya. Pat mo, understand siya, so unsay explain sa iya, no. Related form of media, through narrative, syempre, because you're explaining something, you're describing something. So, it's more on narrative, no, storya. So, usually, linear presentational. Usually, same text acquired simultaneously by many people. Unsay mga activities, no? Or mga tools nga pwede na ito magamit through the acquisition nga teaching and learning event. Pwede ito magamit og non-computer-based activity like TV. So, dili man siya two-way. Ang ilang, well, di man siya interactive, no? Kay, syempre, TV is just there to like discuss on magpalantaw kag video ba no nga discuss lang siya, explain lang siya what are is the standards, for example, ICT policies, pero you cannot give feedback, kadi mo sila maka-receive og feedback, no, kayo murag one side lang siya kind of ko ano. So TV, video, lectures, books, and other print publications. So there's no interaction basically because you're just demonstrating. Okay, ka demonstrate ka, discuss lang ka. Sa end part ni student, naminaw lang siya, no? Sabot lang siya sa mong gina-discuss dira. And kung computer-based activity, you have lecture notes online, okay? Streaming videos of lectures. So, muna, no? Kanang akong mga videos, one side na po siya, no? Dili siya interactive. Kay, muna, parang mga recorded videos na ko, isa pa mo, discuss ko niya, na kay pangutan na, masking mangutan na pa ka dira, dili ko katubag because I cannot receive your feedback. And once you send your feedback, di na ako siya madawat. Nga na ba kay? Kaya naman, no, you're just watching a video. There's no, like, means for you to have an interaction with me. Okay? Lecture notes ka na mga slides or mga handouts gipang upload sa inyong learning management system sa inyong Google Classroom. Those are one way lang siya, no? Di man siya ingon nga. Hatag og lecture notes niya. You can interact with it, no? DVD, multimedia, including video, audio clips, and animation. So, it's usually like a traditional way of getting information na I lecture si student maminaw ra. And these are the non-computer-based and computer-based activities that you will get out of it. Next, Okay, next is ang discovery. So, ang discovery, ano na siya yung mga interaction, no? Kasi mga minimal interactions lang. So, you create or set up or find out or guide through discovery spaces and resources. So, in here, the student is not just only listening lang, no nga, lingkod lang siya, absorb lang siya nga, absorb sa unsay itudlo nimo. and discovery, the students are also allowed to explore further, to investigate, to discover things more on their own. Okay? To add on sa ilaha pa dyan na nakatunan. Okay? So, tagaan po sinilin mo sila o kanang freedom or independence to investigate, to become more curious, no? To try to, ano, browse more information, more knowledge. Okay? So, ikaw, wala ka ga-feed nilang information. Imura silang ginaguide mo, no? Guide. No? You guide through the discovery spaces and resources. Okay? So, mura ka guide on the side, not sage on the stage. Okay? So, nara ka sa side, no? You guide them throughout the discovery process. Okay? So, guys, I have put several ng mga kuandiri, no? Mga materials for you to see. I want you all to just look at it one by one. Do not touch it. Mulantaw lang dyan mo. You can become inquisitive about it, no? Pero, lantaw lang dyan mo, observe, and then you try to, siguro mo, get ka og marag reflection out of it, no? Mag-reflection. Pero kanang marag, mo i-analyze, kung saan siya nga thing, no? Once you observe it, no? Or you try to discover daw, kung saan sila. Okay? You can do further research about it. Mamayang ana. Okay? So, usually interactive na siya. Okay? And it's non-linear because you don't follow certain steps, no? In order to acquire information, like you discover it on your own, maybe in the middle of the activity or during the beginning or even on the end. So, non-linear presentational, it's searchable, filterable, but no feedback. Okay? So, although the students are allowed to explore, but there is still no feedback because it's non-communicative. Okay? Yan na sa dialogue, ang communicative na siya, no? So, there's no feedback because si teacher in this part, igura siya mo guide, mga bata ang mo-explore on their own, pero dili jud ingon nga sila ang, like, na-adjud conversation between nila. Okay? So, you can do that through library. So, for example, mapa-library work ka sa mga bata. Okay, class, I want you to do research work. Let's go to the library. I want you to read books on biology and write anything that you can find that discusses about the respiratory system. And then, muna siya. Oh. Then, submit your research work to me. Galleries, museums, muna siya, mga non-computer-based activity. Kaya wala man siya gagamit, should basically ICT, no, in here, no? Wala man siya gagamit, should technology in here. Ni mga libraries, galleries, museums. And again, it's no feedback, per interactive rin noon siya. Examples of computer-based activity, CD-based, DVD, or web resources, including hypertext, enhanced hypermedia, multimedia resources, also information gateways. Search sa internet, no? You go to Google Scholar. You try to search for articles starting from 2018 that discusses about the integration of ICT in education. Highlight the important conclusions by each research paper, no? And try to synthesize everything for me, write it on a piece of paper, then submit it to me. Tingnan na. So, muna, there's still no interaction because sila raman ang ma-explore on their own, but lang answers ginasulat ra nila din ginasubmit the teacher without any feedback from the teacher and the student. Okay? Next is si dialogue. So, for dialogue, you have set up, frame, moderate, lead, facilitate discussion. So, more siya on mga think, pair, share, mga collaborative groups, no, mag-discuss sila, no? So, sa part ni student, it's discussing with each other, they collaborate, they do reflection, they even argue, no, na may uba na, no, nga, they argue because there is already feedback between one classmate to another or even the teacher to the student. They do analyzing and sharing of ideas. So, atong gibuhat atong activity, atong pag-Monday, that's an example of a dialogue wherein you discuss with each other, you collaborate, you synthesize what you all have shared, and then discuss it in front of the teacher for your classmates to hear. Okay? That's the dialogue teaching and learning event. Okay? So, sa teaching action strategy, on my part, nag-set up ako og mga guidelines, nag-moderate ako nga off. Kung ano ha, 10 minutes ra mo allowed aning activity, then facilitate discussions, like, oh, kinsay mo una, kinsay mo sunod, and then right after pag-discuss ni student, kuha na po, no, kuha na pong gina gina-process, no, unsa ayang ipang storya, add-on po ko sa gishare ni student. Add-on or just give feedback. Okay? Then, communicative conversation with other students, lecturer, or self are the related media form. So, in a form of non-computer, so muna na, tutorials, conferences, seminar, mga groups, no, na mag-talk sila personally. Ang computer-based activity is kano mga discussion forums like Reddit. Are you familiar with Reddit, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, Reddit is an example of a dialogue.
Yes, ma'am.
Because those are discussion forums, blogs. There are even communities that talks about the same thing. I remember when I was still active in Reddit way back before the pandemic, way back before I was employed in the college department. I used to tambay ko kami, no? I used to spend a lot of my time in Reddit reading conspiracy theories. For example, if I've watched like mga thriller nga mga salida na yung mga theories nga nang gawas dira mimang basa. What else, no? Similar interest po nga parehas anang plot sa books, no? Or mga fictional nga. I'm more into anime po. So, mga nga na. Nang po yung mga educational po, mga nga nga discussion, dira po na sa Reddit. Okay. Ang hilig ako kanang mga kuandron, kanang mga stoga na sa Reddit, ha? Kanang mga kuan nila, mga true crime, no? Wadyo na akong mga hilig sa una. Until karon, I'm still into it, pero ginalesa na lang ako, no? Kay, syempre, either busy or lahi na po ang mga ginahan nga lantawon. So, those are examples of discussion forums because there's a community where people are personal, no? Kanang pareha sila og interest or it's a forum wherein gashare lang sila anything under the sun. Then, naray mo, upvote, mo down, upvote if feel nila nga kaning comment kay adds more to the discussion, diba? Or through email because there is, you know, there is feedback, okay? Kung mo ask ka dito, no, usually to receive an answer. And Reddit is not only limited to like mga likes lang po nimo, no? If, for example, if you have problems with your computer or naa kay need ipa-fix, no, pwede ka mo ask sa Reddit and then there's a community that will respond to you. Mga blogs, mga yung ano. Next is practice. Now, that's the fourth teaching and learning event. So, under the Laureliad, no, nga framework. So, ang iyahang teaching, action or strategy is ang model, no? Model na teacher. Yung model nga mag-posing-posing na teacher. Okay. And then, ang learning action or experience ni student is practicing, experimenting. So, sa maning model nga atong ginasturya, no? So, for example, si teacher mo demonstrate siya, okay? Today, we're going to make several nga mga chemicals. So, this is how you're going to do it. Muna mga chemicals yung gamiton. Step by step, mo ni siya. So, ma-demonstrate sa kauna. And then, after, sila na dayon, no? They will do the same experiment. They will put into practice what they have learned from you. Okay? Under learning action or experience. Related media form, feedback, learning control. Non-computer-based activity on saman. Laboratory, like what I've said, no? Mixing chemicals, baron. Field trip. So, usually sa field trip, di man na pwede nga, wala po kay tour guide. So, there will always be someone who will guide you, discusses things, no? Ikaw, narin po ka dito nga. Either you are left out to explore on your own. Simulations, role play. And then, ang computer-based activity, drill and practice, tutorial program, simulations, virtual environments. Okay. So, for example, no, if you're a pilot or a student pilot and kanang dili pa man jud kay anak pa ka proficient to fly a plane, so ato ka sa kanang mga kuano, mga augmented reality, mga simulations. Oh, that's part of computer-based activity. So imong screen as if naa ka sa sulod sa cockpit sa airplane, pero computer ra na siya dayon. Syempre demonstrate mo na una sa inyong instructor before ikaw na mismo ang mo apply ana sa virtual reality or sa inyong simulation nung ana ito sa my computer. Okay. Ug dako kay siya, syempre kay musulod ko sa kamarag room. And then naa siya seats, naa siya controls as if naa ka sa actual airplane, actual cockpit sa airplane. So ang screen dahil ngayon, bis black mo, turn na siya into like the actual dyan siya nga, kung ano, actual dyan siya nga environment ko nuhay. Nya kung masayo po ka o fly sa plane, no, as if mo crash po ang plane. Pero exactly mo crash in real life, it's just like a simulation lang. Okay? Ang last part is ang creation. So, under creation, so wala man din, no, pero naasa to ang group chat. You can just look at it, no? Under creation, ang teaching action or strategy is facilitating. So, under dire, sa creation is facilitating. So, ikaw sa teacher mo, facilitator ka. Okay? So, medyo higher na ni si creation eh, because ikaw na mismo mo create. Okay? Kung mag-analyze mo ko kagun, maraka ga-breakdown. Diba? Ga-breakdown. Pero, this is not just analyzing, you're creating from scratch or creating from basing from something. So ikaw mismo sa student, ikaw na mismo ang muhimo. Okay, so mag-facilitate na si teacher, then si ang learning action or experience, so diri nga part under creation is articulating, experimenting, making and synthesizing. So mo na ang synthesizing is part of creating, wala man diri, no, pero naa sa screenshot. Managani isa koan, Bloom's taxonomy, synthesizing is building. And analysis is breaking down. Okay, analysis is, analyze man nimo ko. Unsa man ang akong i-come up ng conclusion ani, I have to break down the several important, i-highlight ako mga important parts of this problem for me to fully analyze and understand what it means and what is the correct answer. Analysis is breaking down. Mahimo mo ka questions, kung ginahan kag mo breakdown dun sila. Dili, breakdown mo hila ka. So, breakdown, mo break, i-breakdown dun nila. Ha? Analysis ka. Case study. O, yung ana. Na ay case problem dira. Nila nang i-analyze to come up with answers. Pero, if you want them to create something, essay. Essay ba ka? Or make, mayabi ka, make a model. Dili, model nga ka ng babay. Make a model, like a framework. No, maghimo kag imong own nga schematic diagram out of these variables, independent of dependent variables. So, may nga na, no, ikaw mismo mag-create, ikaw mismo maghimo. Kitagaan ako ni ma'am og independent of dependent variable. Ako nang kwaon, then ako na siyang himon into a schematic diagram. Nga na. So, mana, under related media form, under dire sa creation, wala dire sa, again ha, wala dire sa slide na sa screenshot sa GC. So, learner control and it's productive. So, again ha, kung si acquisition narrative, more on talk, discovery more in interactive, they get to interact with their environment and discover things, but there is no feedback. Walay feedback, one way na Japan siya. Si dialogue is more on communicative, na ay feedback between student to student, teacher to student. Si practices is more on adaptive. Nakita na ko si teacher, nag-demonstrate siya ani, ga-expect si teacher nga ako ang ma-replicate. So, that's adaptive. I'm adapting what is presented to me by the teacher. So, si teacher, nag-demonstrate sa kong tubang, ano, dapat ha, yan ini siya pag fruit carving. Oh. So, ikaw, galant akong teacher, ay, nga na, di ay, then ako na po. No? Kung i-put into practice, mag-kuan ko. Fruit carving. Okay? Adapt na ko sa gitudlo ni teacher. Yang gi-demonstrate. Sa creation, it's more unproductive. Kaya, siya mismo ang muhimo, no? Making, mana siya articulating, experimenting, making, synthesizing, building mana ang synthesizing. Mana, no? So, yes, someone raised their hand. Hello? May question? I was in a... Ah, yes, dai.
So far, ma'am.
Ah, okay. Padayon ta. Ah, siya, abit na kong man.
So far, ma'am.
Ay. Ako niya, sakit na kayo kung tutun lang. At the same time, mo, andam na po gusto kong next subject. Na po ko yung klase sa UNESCO's. As a son na di ay. Okay. So, under sa related media form, under ani is learner control. An example of non-based activities sa creation is essay, object, then animation, then model. Yung masag own model, abi for example, or may masag own animation out of it, essay. Examples of computer-based activity, so, simple existing tools, as well as a specially created programmable software. So katong gihimo na mo sa robotics nga naghimo mig among own nga mga patterns no. Although maraming po siya og kanang practice pud no kaga demonstrate ang teacher din ang murang gisunod. Pero na time dito nga we are allowed to make our own sentences. So make our own sentences ato nga mugawa siya sa robot naman ni magamay nga screen ang robot nga mga LED lights raman na so magform siya patterns so we're allowed to do that on our own so pwede pa siya mag-creation na mag-program kag imuang kag galingon nga code para mo ti mugawas no nga code or mugawas nga pattern. Okay, so mura na siya ang first pa niya framework under ICT integration, which is the Laurel Yad framework. Sa exam, na ako'y ipang-tang-tang diri, so yun yung hanang i-familiarize ang Laurel Yad framework. Okay, napot yung mga essay po, mga yung anak. Pero mga anak, ako'y pang-tang-tang diri, yun yung hanang familiarize. So, upload ako itong mga ISTE standards, tagalan na itong copy ato. And that is it for my class. Next meeting na lang, dito ka home, no? Next meeting na lang ang three fundamental elements by Wang. Social interaction, pedagogy, technology. Then, kaning mga categories for information, technology, training. Part na niya ni teacher, actually. Then, kanisya sa UNESCO. Sana na ito niya na ako. Klase lang taan ni Onya on Monday. You have any questions? Before we will end our class early. Okay.
None, ma.
We are going to check your attendance. Okay, once you are present, you can click the raise hand button or you can unmute your microphone and say present, ha? So, chat 31, 29. Okay, Corbita.
Present them.
Okay, Doom.
Present them.
Ma'am, naana siya sa ina, ma'am, pero na-live siya, ma'am, kinahutdan o glow.
Present, ma'am.
Filia Forte.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, Agravante.
Present, ma'am.
Pandoro.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, Apatan.
Present.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, Barbon.
Present, ma'am.
Gonzales.
Present.
Labaw.
Present, ma'am.
Manayon.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Filia Rus.
Present, ma'am.
Dakulis.
Present, ma'am.
Danilo. Villa Corte.
Present, ma'am.
Okay, Catalogo.
Present, ma'am.
Girly.
Present, ma'am.
Betty May.
Present, ma'am.
Maria Jenny.
Present them.
Bayogo.
Present them.
Present them.
Present them.
Okay. Aronia.
Present them.
Present them.
Present them.
Patulada. Patulada. Sapanan.
Present, ma'am.
Consulta.
Present, ma'am.
Kogonon.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. Janibee.
Present, ma'am.
Okay. So thank you so much, everyone.
Present, ma'am.
We're going to meet next week for the continuation of our discussion. Sadly, di ba na to na mahumad until 4:30 na we have to end early lang for this afternoon. We are going to continue with, I think we have only remaining 3 na lang. No? Tulo na lang kabuok framework, and then we can proceed with, on Monday, we can proceed with samples sa learning plan. Okay? So thank you so much, everyone. See you all on Monday. You may now leave the Google Meet room. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.